Liz has a purse. You know, most ladies do. And all of a sudden, she pulls out a tire pressure gauge.
You have to have one.
A tire. I kid you not. It's Robin Liz on his radio. Good morning.
There it is.
Why? Is that in your purse?
Just in case. If the light goes off in my car that says tire pressure is low, boom.
Put it in a glove box. You don't need that in your purse. What are you walking around with that in your purse for? Are you checking other people's? Or are you like walking through the parking lot going,
I could.
I wonder what their tire pressure. What else do you have in there?
I have a Happy Meal toy.
You don't have grandchildren.
Well, no, but I love kids. I just do. And so if I go through a fast food restaurant, I like to order the Happy Meal. First of all, it's cheaper. And
yeah,
it's all the food
true.
I need. And
don't you know that they are not allowed to give you the Happy Meal if you're not a kid?
Yes, they are.
Did you know that?
At certain places, they can. Okay. They will. And so I collect all these. And so if I ever, you know, meet a new friend and they're shy, and then I give them a little toy, you know, ask the mom and dad if they can have a little toy. So I've got that.
You wanna know there's what else more? Is You're kidding me.
I do have a mask. I have my mask.
Well, that's normal now.
Yeah, okay.
That's not abnormal.
Let's see. I've got some Equal. Is that weird?
No, that's not too weird.
I have a bag of sugar.
Bag of sugar?
A Ziploc bag of sugar.
Why?
I think it was, I don't know. I think it was from Creme Brulee last week, and I put it down in there.
She literally,
and I didn't need
it's a
it.
Ziploc bag of sugar. It looks like something else, but it's sugar. Okay, what else? Don't get pulled over by the cops with that.
Let's see,
what?
I'm just going to grab, I have a pen, lip gloss, mascara.
Well, this is all getting normal now.
This is
a
like,
normal purse now.
Right, but there's a lot
the
of
tire
it.
Gauge. Anything else abnormal?
I'm looking.
Is this like unusual?
What is this thing? This is a wireless charger.
I know what that is. That's one of those ones. Oh, it's swag. It's got a logo on it.
Anybody need a straw?
Straw?
That's
okay.
Straw.
Okay. Here's I just saw bills. She pulled out bills.
Yes.
That's not unusual either.
Yeah, I won't
either.
Show the bills.
So while she's still digging, you're still digging in that thing? How much junk do you have in there?
Well, it's a large purse.
And you just, don't you clean that thing out?
I have fingernail polish.
Guys, bring a garbage can over here. She needs to clean that thing out. Okay, here's what I'm curious about. What about the purse in your family? What odd thing is in that? Is radio going?
It's a chip clip.
Call and text.
His Morning Crew.
I'm not sure why, honestly, why Liz did this on His Morning Crew. It's Robin Liz, by the way. Thanks for listening to His Radio. Mm-hmm. But she was digging through her purse and she pulled out this tire gauge. I'm like, what?
You got to know tire pressure.
You leave it in the car. You don't need it. You walk around. Anyway, so we started thinking at 800-447-7234, the unusual things that could be found in the purse in your family.
We got a text.
Oh, really?
Crystal
okay.
is kind of backing me up here. Crystal, she has a screwdriver in her purse because you never know when you might need one.
I would agree, Crystal.
So if
put a hammer in there, too, and a wrench.
A couple of nails.
Yeah, because you never know when you need to nail something to the wall.
You got
to
have the belt.
A belt? Oh, the tool belt.
Yeah, the tool belt.
Okay.
Not the Batman belt.
You need a utility belt like that. 800-447-7234. Andrea, what about you?
I have a tape measure in there. Don't ask me why. I just do.
You don't even know how that got in your purse.
Oh, I put it in there, but I don't know why, but it's come in handy several times.
How does that come in handy?
At work.
And what do you do?
I'm working in human resources.
Okay.
But yeah. I don't know. I can't remember.
I know what you did. You were trying to make sure everybody was staying 6 feet apart.
There you go.
His Morning Crew.
Kind of crazy when Liz goes into her purse. I don't even know what you were going for. What were you getting in your
purse? I think lip gloss.
Okay. So instead of lip gloss, she pulls out a tire gauge. I kid you not.
And a Happy Meal toy.
Yeah.
There's so many different weird things in there.
It's crazy. It's His Radio, 800-447-7234. Well, evidently, she's not the only one that has something unusual in the purse.
Yeah, Ruth Lee texted in, and she said, I have underwear for my daughter.
I'm guessing she's a toddler.
Toddler.
Yeah.
You have to be, as a mom, you have to be prepared. You don't always want to carry the diaper bag, so there you go.
Yeah, my wife used to do that. She used to carry extra clothes for the kids when they were small.
Right, you would have diapers and baby powder, who knows what.
You
in
need
there.
The essentials for that. Elizabeth's along with us at His Radio. What about you, Elizabeth? What's in that purse of yours?
But at one point, I had this really giant purse that I carried a ton of crazy stuff in. the entire weight of the world on my shoulders, at which point I pulled out a small stress ball globe.
No, you did not. You just so happened to have that in there.
I still have no idea how it got in there.
But man, was it perfect timing.
Exactly.
Rob and Liz.
His Morning Crew.
This is the coolest story. Back in 1983, there was a New York City firefighter who showed up to a house fire, and he ran in because there was a little girl who was trapped. She was 4 years old. He gets her out, goes about his business. She, you know, is whisked away by the family. They ended up moving somewhere else, like states and states away, so she never got to find out really who that firefighter was. Always wondered.
Just a little girl at the time,
yeah,
you said, right?
4 years old, and it was in the newspaper and that kind of thing, but I think she just didn't remember a whole lot about it other than being saved. Years go by, she becomes a nurse, and she's giving back. So she thought, during the pandemic, during quarantine, I'm a nurse, I want to go to New York, I want to help what they're going through right now. So she goes to New York, and all of a sudden, one night, these firefighters come in, I guess for a tour, to give back to the frontline workers. She said, do any of y'all know Eugene? He was a firefighter here years ago.
She just knew the first name?
Well, no, she knew his name, Eugene Puglisi.
Okay.
That's why I stayed away from him.
Well, that's easy enough to find this guy
exactly.
Then.
Exactly. Well,
Eugene Puglisi.
Puglisi. She looked him up on Facebook, on Instagram, all these social media, never could find him. Anyway, one of the firefighters is like, I know Gene. And that's probably why she couldn't find him, because he went by Gene rather than Eugene.
Makes sense.
He said, I got his number. She's like, what? Called him. They talk. They have a great chat. He's 75 years old now, and they haven't been able to meet just because he's vulnerable. She doesn't want to.
COVID-19.
Right. Yeah. She's working in the hospital with the patients every single day, but they have made plans because that was 37 years ago. She's now 41.
This is really stuck in her mind all these years. I don't even remember stuff I did at 4.
I don't know if you went through something like that where somebody came in.
You're probably right.
Like a superhero and saved your life. And so they are making plans that after all this is over, they are going to get together and she's going to give him a proper hug and a thank you.
And I think that's why she's a nurse.
I think so, too.
You know, a firefighter helped her.
He inspired her.
And now she's helping people
being
a nurse.
I just think it's the coolest story.
Rob and Liz.
His Morning Crew.
I don't think there's a lot of world traveling happening right now.
Unfortunately.
COVID-19.
Yeah.
Some of the things that are different, it's going to sound, I hope I say this word correctly, bougie.
Bougie.
Bougie. Okay. It's going to sound bougie. Bougie.
Bougie.
And hopefully I'm
you
using.
You bougied bougie.
Hopefully. I know. I just messed the word up. But the African safaris.
Yeah.
They're like canceled right now.
I know.
And not going to open up until there's one that's going to open up like in July.
Oh, okay.
So what they're doing, and this is a benefit for you and me, because there's no way I can't go and afford a safari in South Africa, you know?
They are super expensive.
Yeah, hello. So Virgin Limited?
Yeah.
They're doing free safaris virtually online every Monday up until when they open back up in July.
That is incredible. So what, like, what? Is it inside the Jeep?
You're like inside the Jeep, and it's like a live virtual thing. This is not like virtual glasses or anything,
right,
but you're literally, they've got the camera in there, they're doing the Facebook thing, and then they're driving right on through like you're right on the safari.
Yeah, the only safari I've ever been on is Animal Kingdom.
You know? Really?
Yeah.
Busch Gardens for
me. Exactly, but this is actually out there like in the wild.
The real deal.
That is, and like you said, it's the only way. Probably you and I would ever be able to afford.
I'd never go on a safari like that. I would love to.
Yeah.
That would be a bucket list kind of thing.
Where else would be on your bucket list to go? If we could travel right now and you had an unlimited amount of money.
Listen, I'm really super into cycling.
Okay.
I love road cycling.
Yeah.
And I've always wanted to travel and do the routes of the Tour de France.
There's
no way I can compete in it because they're young. You know, and I'm out of competition age range.
No.
But I would love to cycle on those roads.
Yeah, because you don't have to
be. Go up the Alps and climb those mountains.
And you don't have to be in the competition to do it and still get that thrill from it.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. I want to go to Israel. I want to go to Italy. I mean, there's so many places that I would love to travel to. But that, of course, if somebody else is writing a check. But
yeah, exactly.
And it were open.
And I'd like to travel. I mean, Amy and I, we've talked about, okay, during retirement years, RV and just hit the road.
Are you the RV guy? Because I think that is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Where would be the first place you'd take off to? And I know it's a road trip, so you'll be stopping other places.
I think we'd visit the kids first.
Yeah?
Because I have a feeling they're going to spread out across the nation.
Does that break your heart?
It does. Anyway. I've already got one out of the state. I've got two that are still here and one that's still in the house. So.
Wow. So Grand Canyon, maybe a first trip after you visit the kids?
My wife wants to go there.
Have you ever been there?
Nope.
Me either.
Don't know. I've only seen the pictures.
What's up with us?
I know.
So where would you go? I want to hear. 800-447-7234. Text or call us. Let us know.
His Morning Crew.
When things start opening up, where would you travel to first? I mean, and if you could just like pick it, if you could pick anywhere, where would it be? It's Rob and Liz, 800-447-7234, radio.
And if you had all the money, you didn't have to worry about money, where would you go? Jenny said Costa Rica, and she wants to go to Japan during cherry blossom season.
Oh, that's nice.
So she knows all about it. She's done her research.
Now listen, if you can't go to Japan to see that, go to Michigan. They have the cherry festival that happens in Michigan. It's like around June, end of June to beginning of July.
I did not know that.
Oh, it's huge. It's in Traverse City, Michigan.
Very cool. Well, Richard wants to go. He said on his bucket list, he's always wanted to make the complete Route 66 run from Chicago to L.A. and just see everything that's out there on that road and drive down memory lane.
Oh, yeah. That used to be a big thing.
It really
back
did.
Back in the day, Route 66. Yeah. Songs about it and everything. Mm-hmm. Hearing from Jess at 800-447-7234. Where'd you go, Jess?
I want to go to Alaska. I've seen the rainforest. I want to go see the tundra. I want to see the northern lights. I want to see the glaciers. I want to go whale watching. That would be a dream for me.
Wow, you have it down. You are a traveler.
I wish.
But you've been to the rainforest, you said.
Yes.
Where was that?
In Costa Rica. I went in college for research. I did research in Costa Rica.
Wow.
What do you do today?
I actually work for Lowe's now. I didn't go further to get my PhD, but I do have a master's.
That sounds very fascinating, though. And you're still involved in wood. I mean, you sell it at Lowe's.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So you're close to the rainforest.
All the time.
Rob and Liz.
His Morning Crew.
Before you know it, things will be a little more wide open.
Yes.
So we can start going places, you know? If you're going to be doing some traveling here really soon, COVID-19, at some point, we'll get behind us. Maybe we got to wear a mask wherever we go. I don't know. It's Rob and Liz on His Radio. So we started thinking, if you could go anywhere, where would you go right now?
If you had, let's just say, an endless supply of money, and travel is a little cheaper right now.
So it's okay to dream.
Yeah. Where would you go? So Angela says she and her husband want to go to Ireland for their 5th year anniversary that's coming up in 2024. So they are still newlyweds.
Okay.
They both have Irish heritage, so they're super excited. They're already saving their money, and they've already gotten books, and they're doing the research.
Okay, I love that, Angela, that you and your husband are already saving to do that. I love the goal that you set. There's so many. We didn't do that. I wish Amy and I would have saved up and say we want to go back and be right in Gatlinburg for our 20th.
Yeah, wouldn't that be cool?
That'd be great.
And then do the research so you know, okay, this is, you know, on Yelp or whatever. This is a place we should go. This is a place we shouldn't go. Yeah, definitely. Love it.
Okay, we're hearing from Andrea as well at 800-447-7234. What about you, Andrea? Where would you go?
Every time I get to work and I turn my computer on, I'm like in awe because they take you to the most wonderful places on my screensaver.
So what was it this morning? Are you already at work?
No, I'm on my way. But, I mean, I just want to pop in there and go, wow, I'm going to sit there all day.
They do have some crazy cool things. I mean, I have an Apple TV, and so it has screensavers that that travel across the planet.
Yeah.
I mean, you're like in Hong Kong 1 minute.
Right.
And then you're in Australia at Sydney the next minute. What are some of the things that stand out on your screensaver?
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
I did a little stalking.
You did?
By mistake.
Okay.
By mistake.
Yeah.
We're friends on Facebook, Liz and I. And I noticed on Facebook she was looking for a Jell-O mold.
Right.
At first, I'm like, what is that? And then I had to Google Jell-O mold, and I saw what it was. So she was looking for one, so I have a sneaking suspicion that tomorrow has something to do with Jell-O and Liz's Ugly Bakery.
I thought, because, and I was not around in the 1950s, but I know that my mom talked about her mom making these Jell-O salad molds.
Mm-hmm.
So I started looking these things up. They're crazy. They're wild. And I thought,
Well, is this like one of those, what is it, Waldorf salads or what do you call them? Watergate salad.
Okay,
yeah.
So no, that is with pudding. That's okay. What Waldorf. Anyway, that's what pudding,
I didn't know.
Pistachio pudding.
Okay.
But no, a Jell-O mold is like, and if you Google this, you will find tomato based.
Ew.
That is disgusting.
Jell-O?
Yes.
Oh, that's sick.
They would put avocado and black olives and
really?
I don't even get. So anyway, I love Jell-O. I absolutely love Jell-O. And so I'm going to make my own kind of creation with my Jell-O mold. It's not going to have vegetables in it. It's going to have fruit in it.
I'll tell you who really looks forward to Liz's Ugly Bakery.
Exactly.
And that's our video department. Both Ian and TJ are
every
always
week,
into it.
What right?
No. So,
what?
No. So what?
Wow. That was just
TJ.
Slammed down, man.
Why not?
Jell-O's nasty. Like,
Jell-O?
Absolutely nasty.
Oh, you're crazy. You're crazy. Dude, Jell-O is my life. Like, Jell-O's always been one of my favorite things ever since I was a kid. I went to Sam's and I got like a pack of like 24 Jell-O cups. I've demolished those things.
The ones with a little fruit in the bottom, because I buy those.
You definitely pushing it now.
No, it's good.
I don't really do Jell-O with fruit.
Do you put Cool Whip on top or whipped cream?
Oh, no, no. That's even worse.
Just straight Jell-O?
Yeah, I'm a bit of a, I'm
okay.
Very exclusive.
You're boring.
To just Jell-O.
So listen. So
what?
TJ, we'll try it tomorrow. Yeah, you will.
Yes, you will.
We need a taste.
Oh, you're gonna try it.
We need a
it.
Taste tester. We're talking about Liz's Ugly Bakery.
Yeah.
It's a Jell-O thing, and the guys are telling us they don't like Jell-O.
Yeah, it's not necessarily baked, but it's so cool to just do those old recipes, I think, and to make it in. A friend of mine is giving me not even letting me borrow it, giving it to me.
Oh, it's for you.
Some Tupperware, a Jell-O mold from 1976.
No way.
Yes, I don't even know what shape it's gonna be in right now.
So it's going to be wasting space in the cabinet.
No, listen. This is going
to
rock your world. Listen, Ian's going to eat it, and he's going to love it. And
with Cool Whip and fruit.
What have I been missing my whole life?
Because you don't like Jell-O.
I'm not a big fan. I'll eat it,
yeah.
But I'm not a fan. I'm not like, I'm jonesing for Jell-O. I'm not like that guy. You know?
The only thing I don't get Jell-O on a buffet. Why?
Oh my goodness, that's all I ever got at the buffet when I was a kid. And to this day, I still get it. Except I don't like when it's out there for too long. It starts getting a little rubbery.
That's
the
best part of it, when it gets just that rubbery, I hate to call Jell-O with a crust,
okay.
But that is awesome.
Listen, oh my goodness,
I'm sorry this went there. I had no idea.
Y'all don't know what you're talking about. Jell-O is awesome.
The whole Jell-O thing would turn
There's
into this.
Always room for Jell-O.
So that's tomorrow's Liz's Ugly Bakery. At 7:10, bon appetit.
Rob and Liz.
His morning crew.
Talking about Jell-O, because it might be, it will be a part, right? That's tomorrow's Liz's Ugly Bakery
at
tomorrow. 7:10. We were learning that one of our video producers, TJ, is like totally against Jell-O. He's boycotting Jell-O. He will never eat Jell-O. He throws Jell-O at people. He doesn't like Jell-O.
I do.
And he even laid down a challenge that I have to ride this roller coaster if he's going to eat the Jell-O.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you ride that roller coaster, I'll eat some Jell-O. I'll put that Jell-O down.
Well, then there you go.
He may not be eating Jell-O tomorrow. Anyway, we got a text from Sharon, and she sent us a picture of her berry pie.
Oh, for real?
She uses Jell-O in it.
In a pie?
Yes.
Okay, that sounds interesting.
I gotta get the recipe. Yeah, definitely. And then we have Heather, and I was talking about that Tupperware Jell-O mold that a friend of mine's letting me use from 1976. She said they last forever. Her mom still has hers, also from the
70s. So how does Tupperware last in an oven?
You don't put it in an oven. That's the thing. Even though it's Liz's Ugly Bakery, it's not an actual, unless I made Sharon's pie, it's not actually going to be a baked good. But I might. I might make two different items.
So you don't cook this thing?
Tomorrow. Not the Jell-O mold.
Okay.
If you did, you'll have an oven full of plastic.
So, okay.
It's not good.
That's what I was thinking.
Okay.
All right.
And then we heard from Carol. And Carol said she likes whipped Jell-O with regular Jell-O cut in cubes, and then it has whipped cream on top.
Oh, really?
I have seen that.
Bradley's with us, 800-447-7234. What's the Jell-O story for you, Bradley?
So when I was younger, my mom made some Jell-O with fruit in it, but she only had grape and orange, and she decided to mix the two flavors together. And when she did, and she put fruit in it, it looked like moldy fruit in dishwater.
Because it turns black almost, right?
Yeah, it was like a dirty gray color. And the flavor was fine. It was fruity, but it looked like it was moldy fruit.
Well, you do eat with your eyes first. So, yes, I understand.
Yeah, so please make sure you don't mix orange and grape.
So, you're not planning that, are you, Liz?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Rob and Liz.
His Morning Crew.
Talking about, of all things, this is world-changing here.
Yes.
Jell-O. Hello.
And I did get a text just this second from Sharon, who gave me her recipe for that mixed berry pie that we talked about earlier. Yeah, she makes a pie using Jell-O.
Yeah, so.
So she gave me that recipe.
I found out by stalking, by accident, Liz's Facebook page, because I always try to figure out, what is she going to make for Liz's Ugly Bakery? She does it Thursdays at 7:10. So she's making something tomorrow. I saw she was looking for a Jell-O mold.
Yeah.
Did I say that right?
Yes, you did.
Sounds like I'm talking about moldy Jell-O, but a Jell-O mold.
No, I hope
and
not.
Then, yeah, and then and it's that's what you're making tomorrow.
Yes, I am going to make, a friend of mine is giving me, I guess, her mom's Jell-O mold from 1976.
And then TJ, who's one of our video producers, is like, nah, I ain't eating that stuff.
Mm-mm.
See?
It just, you're like, there's no discussion with TJ. He just lays it down. I'm not doing it.
He's closed-minded over Jell-O.
Are you a toddler over Jell-O?
A little bit.
Nope. He'll eat it.
Ian doesn't eat anything in his Jell-O, so he might not eat it tomorrow.
That is super boring. I'm sorry, it is.
I'm not entirely against it. I just prefer just plain old Jell-O. Like, that's his personal preference.
No, you got to have some pineapple in there. Oh, it's so good.
We're
and a little whipped
see.
Cream dollop on top.
So we're hearing from Kim at 800-447-7234. What about your Jell-O, Kim?
My grandmother made Jell-O with her Jell-O mold, like Liz was talking about. And it was a green, lime green with cream cheese in it and marshmallows and pineapple and cheese, Jell-O cheese.
Really? I never heard of putting cream cheese in Jell-O.
Wait. You said cream cheese and yellow cheese?
Yes. Shredded yellow cheese and cream cheese. And we just mix it together and it made it Jell-O without cream cheese would just be like a see-through Jell-O green, but with the cream cheese it made it kind of creamier and stuff. So a light Jell-O. And it was fluffy sort of. And so I wanted to make that every Thanksgiving just to keep the tradition going, or Easter, but I have yet to find a Jell-O mold that I want to pay the price for, because they're really expensive.
That's what I heard, yeah.
$30. I mean, I don't need one, that bad. But, and I've checked the thrift stores. I can't find one, but I'm with you all the way with the Jell-O mold and with the Jell-O. But you should try that, the recipe I just told you.
With the cheese, the yellow cheese.
I don't know if I can do the yellow.
Put a little shredded cheese in there.
I get what she says. It cuts that sweetness a little bit, but I want to. I don't know.
Okay, well, try Parmesan. Spring a little Parmesan cheese on there.
Okay.
It'd be great.
Ew.
Just like a little bit of spaghetti.
I won't eat that one.
His Morning Crew.
I was on Facebook the other day, and my cousin posted something about a show that her mom used to make her watch every night. I immediately connected Lawrence Welk.
Oh, she was made to watch Lawrence Welk,
Mom had it on. We only had, three or four channels back then. And so she was like, you're going to watch this. It's not like we have a TV in every room like they do now. So she had to, yeah. And so I was like, oh my goodness, I had to watch Hee Haw.
Remember Hee Haw.
You do remember? Yeah.
I do.
We would switch off. So my dad liked Lawrence Welk. My mom liked Hee Haw. And so this week was his week. Next week was her week. So, yeah.
Yeah.
We were very cultured.
I had a different kind of childhood.
Okay.
So I wasn't made to watch anything because my mom put me in the room when she got home.
Yeah.
So I had a TV in the room and a wicker chair. I could watch whatever I wanted on a little cable box. But my grandmother, when I would spend time over there.
Yeah, what'd you watch?
Okay, first it was the World Series.
Oh, well, go, Grandma. Yeah.
Well, I'm not a guy into baseball.
Maybe
so
that's why.
After she passed away, I'm like, boy, I wish I still would have had those times with Grandma in the World Series, even though I didn't like it as a kid. And then after that, it was Trapper John, M.D.
I haven't thought about Trapper John in forever.
Yeah, spinoff of MASH, and they didn't use the main character from MASH in Trapper John, M.D.
Right.
They used a dude off of Bonanza.
I've got to go.
He had a lot of hair
that.
In Bonanza. He had no hair in Trapper John, M.D.
I do remember that.
So I was made to watch that. I did not like that. I'm sorry. It's just not my thing.
So what did you have to watch as a kid? Your mom and dad, grandma, whoever it was, would not let you change the channel. You had to sit there for a half an hour and watch it.
Yeah, be a part of the conversation. We'd love to hear from you. You can call or text.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
Poor Liz. When she was growing up, her parents made her watch things. Like Lawrence Welk and Hee Haw.
Yeah. We alternated each weekend. It was like, oh, great. And I don't know that I liked either one of them that much. I mean, I don't know. Maybe Hee Haw a little more, but yeah, there you go. So that's what my cousin posted online. She was talking about what her mom made her watch. So we're trying to find out from you what you've watched. And we have a couple. So Therese said MASH and Little House on the Prairie.
She didn't like those shows?
I don't know.
Therese.
Did you like MASH?
I liked both of them.
I liked
actually, I had a really horrible family growing up.
Yeah.
And so I liked Pa.
Who didn't?
On Little House on the Prairie. I wanted him to be my dad because I had no dad.
You wanted to be Albert. Albert is the
little
boy they brought in.
Yes. Young man exactly. Later on in the seasons.
Yeah.
And I wanted to marry Laurie Engel.
Oh, so. Yes, of course you did. Mm-hmm. Michelle said that her mom used to put her in a playpen and mom would take a nap. And so while mom napped, she watched Alf.
Alf?
Yes.
Wow.
I loved Alf.
Alf. Where's the cat?
I forgot that.
Oh, Alf. Okay, Diane's along with us at 800-447-7234. What about you? What did your parents make you watch, Diane?
About Barney Miller.
Barney Miller?
Oh, yeah, the old cop show.
Oh, my word.
What didn't you like about that? Because that was a favorite show of mine.
My mother loved it. Loved it, but Lawrence Welk is the topper. But Barney Miller, it bored me.
I can see because you were young. Like, how old were you when that was on television? She made you watch it.
Probably elementary school.
And there's no 8-year-old on this planet that wants to watch Barney Miller.
Thank you.
So, as far as Lawrence Welk goes, were you into the Bobby and Sissy dance routines?
That's the only thing about it I like. But I looked at mom and I said, if I watch this show one more time, I'm literally going to dream I'm blowing bubbles.
That's funny, Diane. I do not remember. I remember Lawrence Welk.
Okay.
I was a little kid. My grandmother used to watch that, right. But I don't remember any of the dancers.
Oh, Bobby and Sissy. My sister, who's almost 7 years older, she would play Bobby and I would be Sissy because she would lift me in the air and we would, I remember being on the carport.
They did all the dance
and
routines
and doing the
on
routines.
That. Yeah. I need to YouTube this and remember.
I don't think you do.
I don't. Okay.
No.
Maybe we should. She doesn't like it.
Rob and Liz.
His morning crew.
This has been fun. Mm-hmm. Talking about those TV shows that let's go back to your childhood, that you were made to watch because your parents loved it. And you're like, Mom, Dad, or you didn't have a voice in the whole thing.
You really didn't.
Because there wasn't another TV in the house for like 80s and 90s.
Yeah.
2000s get here. Everybody's got a TV in their hand. It's Rob and Liz, his morning crew on his radio.
We got a text from Michelle, and she was made by her grandmother to watch Dallas.
Oh, how horrible.
Friday nights. You know that.
I feel for you.
Who shot JR kind of thing.
Yeah.
Remember that? Yeah. And then Angela had to watch all those judge shows. So it was like Judge Wapner, which was
People's Court. Yeah.
And then Judge Judy.
Oh, that poor guy. Who was this?
This was Angela.
Okay, Angela. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Although I like Judge Judy. I will tell you that. She's still around today. Yeah. She's getting ready for her last season.
Yeah. And sometimes you get sucked in by Judge Judy.
You do.
Like, you're like, that didn't have what?
That
what'd he do?
Really happened? Okay, earlier, I don't know if you heard Liz, but she alluded that there was two shows. One was Lawrence Welk. The other one was Hee Haw.
That mom and dad alternated each week to watch.
Oh, the joys of live TV. So we hear from Robert, and Robert has something very special for you, Liz.
Oh, okay.
This is for Liz from Robert.
Okay.
Robert, go ahead. Take it away, buddy.
Where are you tonight? Wow. why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and thought I found true love. You met another and you was gone.
That's awesome. Thank you, Rob.
You're welcome. I hope you remember that all day long.
I will.
His Morning Crew.
Talk about a practical joke that's been going on forever, it seems like.
Yeah, but it sounds like a practical joke most of us could get behind. There's a guy that has had a mystery pizza delivered to his home. Sometimes it's once a week. Sometimes it's twice a week.
This is so great.
One time he got 10 pizzas in one day.
This has been going on for, are you ready for this? A decade.
He has no idea. He got mad at first. He got mad.
Oh, I would. It's like, come on, quit.
Would you?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know.
How much pizza can you eat in a week?
Well, I have two teenage boys, so quite a bit, but I'd get skeeved out a little bit.
Yeah. Like, why? Enough of the pizzas.
Yeah.
But for, isn't that hilarious? Okay, so here's one thing. There was one time that he got the mystery pizza, uh-huh. and then his friend across town got a mystery pizza. So he's thinking, okay, there's got to be a connection.
Sure.
Because if it's me and my bud across town getting a mystery pizza at the same time, mm-hmm. on the same day, mm-hmm. it's someone that knows us and they're not saying who they are. And the people who deliver it, of course, aren't giving them any kind of clues.
Could you keep that secret that long? I have such a hard time keeping a secret.
Oh, I could.
You could?
Oh, yeah, because if it's bugging them.
Oh, no.
You know, and deliver. Evidently, whoever this is, this person's got some money to continue to do pizzas just about every day, a mystery pizza, for 10 years.
Yeah, and 10 in one day. 10 in one day. So my question was, when I read this, is the guy who's getting the pizzas, getting them delivered, is he having to tip the delivery person? Or is the guy or woman who's ordering the pizzas going ahead and doing that tip?
I would say the person who orders it. Is sending
just
it.
Just adding it. Yeah.
Because that'd be a lot of tip money to always give out, not knowing if the pizza's on its way or not.
Right. And that's the only thing I might get a little upset. Not upset, but just like, oh, really?
I don't have money. I'm sorry, dude. I don't have money today. I can't give my delivery person a tip.
Right. I have no cash.
Yeah.
I don't know. If somebody wants to deliver a pizza to my teenage boy house, that would be fine with me.
Yeah, at least they're in the home for a while.
Exactly.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
You find a fun plug-in that makes you look like an actor or actress, your doppelganger, and then Liz just goes crazy all over it. It's Rob and Liz, his radio. She's actually plugged in our pictures.
Yeah. It's called starbyface.com.
I don't know if you've ever used that or if somebody looks at you and says, you so look like, and then they name the actor or actress, the famous person.
I think that most of us have had somebody say, oh, do you know you look like, my daughter looks like Selena Gomez.
I've gotten Mr. Magoo a lot.
You have not.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Magoo. Well, I did plug in your picture, by the way.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I think you'll be happy with the results.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
You got Mark Ruffalo, who, if you don't know, he plays Dr. Bruce Banner or the Incredible Hulk.
So I look like the Hulk?
Yeah, no, you look like Dr. Bruce Banner.
I want to look like the Hulk with all the big muscles.
Well, I mean, I want the green face.
Yeah.
Is what you want to look
Why
like?
Why not? Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, cut your trousers at the knee and you've got to start.
Rip my shirt all to shreds.
Exactly. And then Jeff Bridges also came up for you.
What's he in?
He's an Academy Award. Oh, gosh. Oh, my goodness. The Fabulous Baker Boys. That's the one I was trying to think of. He was in The Giver.
Okay. Well, if he's a giver, then yeah. I'll take that.
I know. Starman? I can't remember. Anyway, he's
no
been a
Tron.
Tron.
Yeah, that's the Tron dude.
Yes.
Okay, that's not bad.
No, but he's been in a ton and very handsome. I mean, very distinguished looking. So
how did he come up on mine then?
Oh,
if he's handsome,
see, that's the thing. No,
okay.
So then I put my picture in.
Okay, I can't wait to hear what Liz Riles is.
Elizabeth Hasselbeck.
I can see that.
And but she's the only thing is we both have brown eyes.
Okay,
that's the only thing I can see that looks the same. Beyonce. Came up again. I think it all goes back to the eyes
and the smile. Yeah, I see it.
My smile is a little claymation, and hers is not.
Claymation.
It is.
What?
It's a little
claymation.
Look, when I smile, I go just a tick crooked.
Don't force it. You don't force it.
I'm not forcing it. When I smile in pictures,
you're forcing
I look back,
it now. You're going.
Well, see, that's I'm trying to keep my lips straight because when I just smile, it goes claymation. Don't
no,
even.
It doesn't. It's Beyonce.
And
okay.
Then, so you can choose also to look at which guys you look like.
What?
I had Martin Short for one of them. I did not let you see that picture. Anyway, Benjamin Bratt. He's from
really?
Miss Congeniality.
I remember Benjamin Pratt.
Yeah,
okay.
So I'm actually very happy with my pictures. TJ in the video department.
Okay.
I put his
You put our
pictures.
Producers in this?
Yes, I did.
Okay, I want to see what TJ
yeah,
looks like.
So TJ got Mike Myers.
Okay.
I maybe
witty
eyes?
And fun.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But they don't know that when you put your picture in.
Okay.
Okay, and then he also got Stanley Tucci. Those two people look nothing alike.
But
so.
TJ has hair. The other dude doesn't.
Stanley Tucci has been bald for a while.
Okay, now I'm curious about Ian.
Yeah, Ian.
He's
got,
one of our other video producers, by the way.
Yes, yeah, so he got, what's his name again, Ian? Patrick?
His name is Patrick Warburton. He was Kronk on Emperor's New Groove.
He was, but that was a cartoon character. But
right.
I don't think Ian necessarily looks like a cartoon character. Then the next guy is Liam... What?
Liam Aiken. He was actually starred in one of my favorite childhood films, Good Boy, about...
Which none of us have seen.
Dogs from Outer Space.
Okay.
Dogs from Outer Space. Okay.
But the one that really hit the nail on the head for me with Ian
mm-hmm.
is when he put his picture in, Waldo picks up.
Waldo!
Where's Waldo?
We need
right
to do...
Here.
You know what we need to do.
Get him a striped shirt.
And do a Where's Ian?
We do.
When all the social distancing stuff is done...
Yes.
We have to do Where's Ian?
So we would get almost like a fat head of Ian and
no,
and
we put Ian out.
Oh, we put Ian out there.
Yeah, Ian.
Y'all just trying to get me out of the studio is what you're doing.
No, no. We need to do a Where's Ian.
Y'all trying to get rid of
It'll be a scavenger hunt, and you'll blend in with that shirt, just like, you know, on the book.
And if you can find Ian, maybe you win something. We've yeah. got to come up. Okay.
Okay. We haven't done it yet.
No, because
we're social distanced.
Right.
But when we get past this... Where's Ian? Oh, that would be great.
It is. I mean, nail on
that
the head
would be
with
great.
This doppelganger.
Okay, we got to get the costume.
His morning crew.
As we head into the weekend, we're thinking about who you look like.
Your doppelganger.
Yeah, or I should say it like this. Who looks like you?
There you go.
You know? Because you're a unique you anyway, right. So somebody kind of is familiar with you, and there could have been a time that someone came up to you and said, are you... Or you certainly look a lot like. It's Robin Liz, his radio, 800-447-7234.
That would be super cool. Jean texted and said that people tell her that she looks like Julia Roberts. And
oh,
she
for real?
Sent us a picture, and I see it. I see it not only in the eyes a little bit, but definitely the smile, because Julia has that big, beautiful smile. So does Jean.
Jean? So
yeah.
The picture you're showing me right now is Jean?
No, that's actually Julia Roberts.
Where's Jean?
Jean is right here. There you go. All right. See?
I see it.
And the hair. She's kind of got the hair going on, too. So, yeah, I can see that.
I absolutely see it.
And then we have Melody, who said that several times people tell her that she reminds them of the Barefoot Contessa. She's on the Food Network. She's Ina Garten. I love her.
She that real thin girl on the Food Network? I don't know their names.
I don't
names.
Know who that one is. No, but Ina Garten, she just has the sweetest... little face.
Uh-huh.
And so, yeah, Melody looks like her. She said maybe a little bit, but she wishes she could cook like her.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So, well, here's Diane at 800-447-7234. You look like who?
I look like Angie Harmon.
She is drop-dead gorgeous, isn't she?
She is. I didn't age quite as well as she did.
Tell me the first time somebody said that to you. What happened?
I was working in a retail store. And somebody said, has anybody ever told you you look like Angie Harmon? And I said, I'm not sure if I even knew who she was at that time. And I said, no, not really. And I went home and told my husband. He said, you do look like her.
That was so nice, too, that he thinks that. I mean, I'm sure you had to help him remember who Angie Harmon is, right?
Oh, he knew who she was.
Rob and Liz.
His morning crew.
Well, the conversation's really taken off about doppelganger, specifically that person who could be very famous that looks like you at 800-447-7234.
Jeff texted and said, people say I look like the golfer Keegan Bradley. I didn't know who this was, but he sent two pictures. They look just alike. Like, literally just alike.
Wearing the same stuff, too.
Yeah,
the hat and
much.
Everything. That is absolutely amazing.
Right? Okay, so then we got a text from Emily, and she said, "Hey, it's Emily. People have told me since I was a teenager that I look like Mandy Moore, specifically in A Walk to Remember."
Mandy Moore, the This Is Us fame, right?
Exactly. Okay. So this is when Mandy was probably late teens, early 20s. They look exactly alike. But I got to call Emily out here.
What do you mean?
She says she's never seen A Walk to Remember. Hold on. Emily, I need to talk to you. You have got to see this movie.
Why?
It's life-changing.
Why?
It is so, like, it's just tragic.
You said Nicholas Sparks,
it is,
didn't you?
I'm almost 100% positive it's Nicholas Sparks.
Okay.
But it, to me, blows the Notebook out of the water. It's so good.
Really?
Yes. You have to see it, Emily.
Okay,
and
Emily.
They do. They look alike.
If you need a binge weekend.
Right. I'll come
here
watch it
go.
With you, socially distant, 6 feet with a mask.
Yeah,
I will.
She'll bring the popcorn.
Right.
Everything.
Yes. You
really,
have to see
it. Really? It's that good of a movie?
It's so, like, I'm tearing up to think
Kids
about
Kids can watch it?
Yes. I ran through it a little bit in my head, but
yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Well,
that
okay.
It's very good.
All right.
To see it.
It's okay. I'm gonna guess it's a chick flick.
Yes.
So the husbands need to go out.
No, you can watch it too. Yeah. You and Amy should watch it this weekend.
Chick flick. Chick flick. No, I'm not good with chick flicks.
Oh, Rob Dempsey.
Seriously, I'm not.
You need to. You said you watched The Notebook.
I got no.
What do you think?
I got like 20 minutes through The Notebook.
Yeah.
And went chick flick.
I'm not a chick flick person. Even though I'm a chick.
Evidently you are.
There's a couple that absolutely, like I say, are life-changing. And A Walk to Remember is one of those. And then The Notebook is definitely. And still Magnolias. I mean, you got
to watch. Closest thing to a chick flick I get is Star Wars.
Yeah. What? Even the guy said, what?
Yeah. And Rocky. There's Rocky, too. There's a love story in Rocky.
Way underneath.
It's Rocky and Adrian.
Beating each other to
a
pulp.
That's a love story.
Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. You're so wrong. You need, Amy, if you need a girls' weekend,
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
Would love to see some of the pictures that you took over the weekend. We'll feature them on His Radio TV. What was it like for you? Did you go hiking, spend time at the pool, do something with the family? Text those pictures now to His Radio. It's 800-447-7234. Rob and Liz with His Morning Crew.
If you've ever been to a wedding, maybe yours, where you had a DJ, somebody playing the music, you know, it's always set up where when the bride and groom enter the reception area, there's usually a song that's played. They introduce them as man and wife from the first time. So Chelsea and Darren were going into their reception area. They were supposed to come into Can't Help Falling in Love, big Elvis song, right?
Yeah.
But all of a sudden, Darren stops everything and plays a song instead for his new bride, Chelsea.
That's an old classic.
Yeah, but it's not Judy Garland. That is Chelsea's grandmother.
No way.
Yeah, she passed away in 2005 from ALS. They had this really, really close relationship, and that was one of the things that Chelsea had told her husband, Darren, that she wanted. She would have loved to have had her grandmother there at the wedding. So he did a little digging around, and I guess Chelsea is kind of the historian of the family, and she had some of these old recordings and old photographs, and he made sure that grandma was part of the reception.
That is so beautiful. Beautiful. And you can hear the record scratching on this, too. That was her grandma.
And when grandma was like a teenager, maybe?
Amazing. Beautiful voice.
Yeah, but it just brought Chelsea to tears that he thought of doing that and followed through.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, that guy's a keeper.
His Morning Crew.
Brian and Liz, not me, somebody else, they were out on their boat one afternoon, and they were just enjoying their day, and all of a sudden they saw something in the water, and they thought it was a dead fish, but they wanted to investigate. I do the same thing. It's so weird.
Do you really?
Why. Yes.
You see a floater, and you're like, okay, I'm going to go see what this is.
Yeah, so I'm like, Joey, go over there and see. Okay, thankfully they did, because what they saw was a baby deer.
Oh, no.
A fawn. I mean, tiny little thing. So they pull up beside it. They pull it up on the deck of their boat. Another guy is actually a kid, it looks like, maybe a teenager, is in a boat very close to them, pulls up beside them to see what's going on. This deer is, you know, had been under the water. They don't know how long, it wasn't breathing. So the kid and the husband gave the deer CPR. It was crazy.
And?
Oh, the deer is fine.
Really? They saved the deer's life?
They did. So they went back and forth. So the kid did it a little while. Then the husband did it for a little while. Did chest compressions, actually breathed through the baby deer's nose and mouth, which was amazing. And all of a sudden, the little deer started kicking just a little bit. They felt the heartbeat. And so after it all, the husband and wife took her to a rehabilitation center. So like a vet. And then and no update. I want to reach out to them if I can find them and say, how's the deer doing? But yeah, they saved its life. Right. And I think
the little Bambi, Thumper, and all the other animals are off to the side cheering on.
I know. Thumper was very happy they saved his best friend.
I'm sure he was.